argue to fight over the speaker. Excuse me. That's not my problem. I just think it's a little embarrassing it's taking so long in the way they're dealing with one another. And the rest of the world's looking. They're looking at, you know, can we get our act together? And, what I've focused on is getting things done. And the one thing I'm going down to Kentucky and Ohio today is to demonstrate we can get things done. We passed an enormous bill, bipartisanly, and it worked. And we're starting off the first major initiative. We're announcing today is $1 billion. This is, we can't be the number one economy in the world unless we have the number one infrastructure in the world.
Who do you think? If any part of you, well, first of all, who do you think the speaker is going to be?
I have no idea.
Okay. If any part of you enjoying seeing the other party having such a hard time right now?
No. And I really mean, look, how do you think it looks to the rest of the world? We're finally coming out of, you know, the first time we're really getting through the whole issue related to January 6th. Things are settling out, and now, for the first time in 3 years, and I really mean it. I know you know international relations. It's not a good look. It's not a good thing. It's the United States of America. And I hope they get the act together.
And what's going to happen if there is no speaker for a week or a month? What's the impact?